Be the night of recovery, a night of destiny recovery. Spirit of God, we ask, come now, come now, come now, come now, and take control. We can't do without you, Lord. Come now, take control. Blessed be God. Father, we depend on you tonight. Today is the first Friday in the month of June 2020. Bible says the horse is prepared for a battle, but safe is of the Lord. Moses says, if your spirit will not go, suffer us not to leave. Lord, this tonight we are praying and asking that your spirit will go with us. Let there be a divine, O God, reshaping of destiny tonight. As many that is going to connect with us online or watch us later, Lord, we trust God that the same Spirit that raised Jesus Christ from the dead will flow to them right now. Thank you, because destiny will reshape it today. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. I welcome everyone to A Hope Today. But tonight is our Destiny Recovery Night, being the first Friday of the month. And I trust God that the Lord will use me to minister to you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Now tonight we want to look on a message titled The Mystery of the Night. The Mystery of the Night. Night have a mystery. Mystery of the night. I'm going to show you about seven mysteries of the night, then we're going to pray. But please, when you come online, just like the page and share, and also stay with us, because we're going to spend quality time to pray and trust God for the move of His power. This time does not separate God of not moving, no matter where you are watching from. Just connect with us. The same power that we experience in this place right now in the studio, it will flow to you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The mystery of the night. Now, our text is going to be from Exodus chapter 11, verse 4 to 7. Exodus 11, chapter, verse 4 to 7. The mystery of the night. Exodus chapter 11, verse 4 to 7.
And Moses said,
yes,
thus saith the Lord, about midnight will I go out into the midst of Egypt. And all the firstborn in the land of Egypt shall die.
Mm-hmm.
From the firstborn of Pharaoh that sitteth upon his throne, even unto the firstborn of the maid servant,
yes,
that is behind the mill, and all the firstborn of beasts. Verse 6. And there shall be a great cry throughout all the land of
Allah.
Egypt,
yes,
such
Lord.
As there was none like it, nor shall be like it anymore.
Mm.
But against any of the children of Israel shall not a dog move his tongue,
yes,
against man or beast,
mm-hmm,
that you may know how that the Lord doth put a difference between the Egyptians
and the
Israelites.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The mystery of the nine. When God give Moses assignment to go to Egypt and rescue his people, there's a lot of sign that was done in the days and all that, and the magician challenged some of other signs. But the last joker card was in the night. And the Lord began to speak to Moses. He said, in this night, I'm going to move all through the land of Egypt. He said, but tell your people they should mark their door with the blood. He said, but when I see their blood, I will pass over you. So the last joker card, the last move of God in Egypt was done at night. And Bible said that night that the spirit of death began to move all over Egypt. You see, every firstborn will die, including their cattle. You see, but to the children of Israel, not even a dog were permitted to die. In Goshen, there was no cry. But in Egypt, there was cry. I want to speak to the nation today that there's going to be a sign that's going to shock the world that will cause all this pandemic to end suddenly. There's going to be a sudden signs in the world. There's going to be a shaking. So mighty men who thought they are mighty men, nobody can do them anything. They're just going to give way. Because God is going to move to the world and rescue his people. Mystery of the night. Now, a night prayer is stronger than day prayers. Night prayer is stronger than day prayer. If you don't believe me, ask those who are praying in the night. As a matter of fact, 1 hour praying at night is equivalent to about 7 hours in the daytime. Because in the night, there's a lot of things that's going on in the night. Hallelujah. The mystery of the night. The mystery of the night. Prayer is the only meeting place between God and man. Prayer is a mystery of itself. That's why no wonder Jesus Christ commanded us. He said, when you pray. So prayer is mandatory. It's not if you pray. When you pray, say. So every child of God must learn to pray. Prayer is a mystery. Because prayer is a way whereby we can align ourselves to the will of God. Prayer is alignment of our destiny with the will of God. When we pray at night, we come at the daytime that look like God. Bible says that when Moses went to the mountaintop to pray for God to give him the commandment, he said when he came down, the people couldn't behold his face. Why God changed him to look like a man. Because where God dwells, you can't even see God. So when you see a man that prays so much at night, when they come out at the day, their life is changed. That is what we're going to do tonight. Praise Jesus. So prayer is an advantage for the Christian against the world. The world we live in is not meant for, if actually, the world we live in is being controlled by the devil, not even God. Why do you say that? Because Jesus Christ said, my kingdom is not on earth yet. Because all this rubbish going on the world today cannot happen in heaven. So you should understand that what is happening on earth today, the devil have been given the permission. But in heaven, they can do it. That is why a man and a woman who can overcome what is going on earth is to be a man or a woman who can pray. A man and a woman who can lay hand on the altar of God, say, Lord, I want to pray until things happen. Prayer is an advantage for the Christian. Prayer, you don't need to be educated to pray. You don't need to be rich to pray. You don't need to buy prayer. Prayer, you need to utter it from your heart. And the disciple said, teach us how to pray. Even as John taught his disciple to pray. So what we're going to do today, tonight, is to pray the will of the Father on earth. He said, that kingdom come, that will be done as it is in heaven. So what that means that we can recreate heaven here on earth, even though we've not gone to heaven. Because in heaven, there's no sickness, so we can create a good health here on earth. We can create our prosperity here on earth. We can create peace in our domain here on earth. So when a man pray, or a woman pray, it become a wonder unto his enemies. Prayer is an advantage that we could leverage on as a child of God. At my young age as a Christian, you know, where our church was in a hybrid area, the rich are, in fact, my brother and I were the only poor people from the family. Every people, what I mean, poor, mean every people. Some of the minister, their sons, the ambassador, their bank MD, CEO, captain of industry. And I told my younger brother, I say, the only advantage we have over these men's children is for to pray. Because if we didn't pray, we don't have no advantage. And we begin to pray. Do you know that the men, these big men, their children, they begin to come to us for counsel? Why? Because we got an advantage over them. Why? Because we spend time in the place of prayers. Now, when it comes to Christianity, prayer is my major cause. Prayer is my major cause. Most of the time, I will run to the prayer mountain and begin to spend all night praying in the prayer mountain. Praying the mystery of God. When you see a man who prays so much in the night, he commands his day. He commands his day. For he spoke to Jacob, Job said, have you commanded your day since the morning? When you see a man that comes from the mountaintop, it's a man that commands attention. When you pray, you begin to look like God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, I want to share with us seven mysteries of midnight prayer. Number one is a major decision is taken at midnight. Major decision is taken at midnight that manifested at the daytime. All this is going on in the world today. There's some cackle, some group of people who have taken decision at night. Would they just wake up and say, this is what we're going to announce? Everybody must do that, everybody must do that. So major decision is taken at midnight. President of nations, some of them, they don't meet at data, they meet at midnight. When you see a man that spends his quality time at night, it's a man that can control his day. It's a man that has strength. So major decision is taken at midnight and they are manifested at the daytime. When you see a person who is sick at daytime, something happened at night. I, as a pastor, I have a story of people, they just wake up and they were sick. But when they went to bed, they were not sick. Why? When men slept, the enemy came and sowed tears. When men slept. Some years ago, I was counseling a sister in Dobsonville in South Africa here. And she said, Pastor, all my body's been marked. I said, what happened? And she showed me her hands. I said, even if all my body's been marked everywhere. You look, I see they use razor to cut her. I saw what happened. Say, when you wake up, you saw this mark. Now, in the daytime, they cannot mark her because she will react. But when she sleeps, they come and mark her. Where men slept, the enemy comes and sow tears. Child of God, there's no time to sleep. This lockdown in nature, some people are walking at home. This is not time to watch TV. This is not time to play game on your computer. Spend some quality time to pray so they can control your day. Because the devil is taking decisions over the righteous every night. While we are watching TV, while we are playing games, while we are chatting on Facebook and all that, they are taking decisions over destiny. Nothing happens in the daytime without night not knowing. Mystery of the night. Hallelujah. So we need to take advantage of this. Number two, destiny are exchanged at midnight. Destiny eyes change at midnight. When you see people begin to misbehave at daytime, children begin to misbehave at daytime, something happens at night. Some parents will just begin to beat their children at daytime and say, why is that you are dull in school? Why is that you are misbehaving? Ask God, what happened at night? What happened at night? Where did this instant? The enemy came and saw tears. Mystery of the night. Destiny has been exchanged at night. It's a trading platform at night. Hallelujah. They take both destiny and go. Now, it is midnight that the enemy walk on fires. They walk on fire. Now, the devil is all over the place. It's not only in Africa or wherever, or the Caribbean. I've seen people, even the white, they come and tell me some things that shocked me that the devil have done. Destiny have been exchanged at night. Destiny. You could see a man or a young boy who was doing well, in school. All of a sudden, give it 1 or 2 years, it begin to nosedive. What happened at midnight? You see a young boy who enter university. He was not smoking. He was not on drugs before he left the home. At campus, somehow something happened at midnight. Why did some girls go into prostitution? Something happened at midnight. Their soul have been mortgaged. They are trading with their soul. He said there's a platform that the enemy trade with soul at midnight. Praise the Lord. People die more at midnight than daytime. Because at midnight, I asked the doctor, at midnight, some of the nurses, some strange sickness come at midnight. The enemy come and choke people at night, take over their lives. So destiny has changed at midnight. 1 Kings chapter 3, verse 20. I'm going to read the scripture for you. This is the account of two women. They were sleeping at night and something happened. 1 Kings chapter 3, verse 20 to 21. It was at midnight that the woman noticed that the child was dead. Not in the daytime. Destiny was changed. Have you seen it? 1 Kings chapter 3, verse 20 to 22. Read it for me, please.
1 Kings chapter 3, verse 20.
Yes.
And she arose at midnight,
not in the daytime.
My son from beside me.
Uh-huh.
While the handmaid slept.
What am I slept?
Laid it in her bosom.
Come on.
And laid her dead child in my bosom.
Can you see what sleep can do?
And when I rose in the morning,
to give my child suck.
He was dead.
Considered
it in the morning.
Yes.
Behold, it was not my son.
It's not my son. They exchanged the son at night. If the woman were at wake, that woman cannot take the son and give the dead child. She was sleeping, down sleeping. And they brought a dead child and took our child. He said, no, when he woke up, he said, no, Sunday happened at midnight. This is not my child. Please, brethren, child of God, if you want to control your day, please be strong at night. Special quality time to pray at night. How can a woman wake up and saw a dead child? It happened at night. Take control of your destiny. Destiny has been exchanged at night. We're going to pray today. I'm going to show you things that are going to happen. When you see destiny being exchanged at night, something happened. A woman that was giving breastfeeding baby before she went to bed. But when she slept, that woman came, the maid came and dropped a dead child, took her own life child. What kind of a woman is that? That you are sleeping, somebody can come and take your child and you didn't wake up. Come on now. It's bad. If that woman was awake praying, and in fact, if you're not even praying, if you're awake, nobody can do anything. Most of the time I go to the prayer mountain, I just begin to shake my head all day long. Because when you are awake, have you had people who say, well, the enemy came to feed them at night? When you are at wake, can someone bring a food and give to you? No. Some people have a dream in the night, say when they dream, they saw excreta and they pour excreta on them. They can't do that to you when you're awake. You confront them. Destiny has been exchanged through the night. Tonight is a night of recovery. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to speak as a prophet sent by God. Amen. Mm-hmm. Number three, midnight are a time of visitation, either by the angels or the devil or by God. Midnight are a time whereby there's a visitation by being that you can't even understand. When you have heard a story about magician, when magician go, when they want to get power, they put a ring on their hand and go to the cemetery, and they will sleep at night. He say at mid, some of them say at midnight the demon come remove the rings in their hand, put another magical ring. When you see people performing magic on TV, don't laugh. Something happen at night. The more you look at them, the less you see. It's that it's a time of visitation. They will come. So the angel can either visit you at night or the devil visit you at night. So night hour is a time of visitation. Luke chapter 1, I think chapter 1 verse 26, talking about Mary. The angel came to visit her at night. I said, hey Mary, that's your concern. I have a child. It was at night. When you have dreamed, most of your dream that terrify you is at night, not even in the daytime. And those dreams happen between, especially 1 o'clock to 3 o'clock. Because that's the time that the enemy are permitted to go and begin to do something. Most bad dreams happen at that time. So if you can take hold of those hours, I tell you, you conquer your life. You conquer your life. People don't just misbehave anyhow in daytime. Something happened at night. Before death come, they are planning at night. Praise Jesus. I was counseling a young lady here in South Africa, and there was a particular place. You see, at that spot, you see, they go there at night. So that they will do some things and all that. I said they meet there. You see, so the first vehicle that will be going on that road, no matter how careful the driver is, must get an accident, it will die, and they will suck their blood. And I said, that is wonderful. I said, but what do people like us go? See, no, people like you, when we see you ahead of time, we'll give way. Because we're taking hold of our day through the night. It is not everybody is killable. Where I said to people, when one died before 70, he was killed, or she was killed. He didn't just die. Take hold of your night. Spend all night praying at the mountaintop. Spend all night praying. And now, even though if you don't want to pray, just stay awake and just begin to shake your head and begin to say, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. You're going to be take hold of your night. Hallelujah. Midnight. A time of visitation. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Number 4. Midnight terminate an old day and open up a new day. Midnight terminate an old day and open up. In other words, a midnight close struggle and open up your destiny up. So if you can take hold of the midnight, you will succeed in life. Hallelujah. Yeah. Take hold of your night. Job chapter 28, 38, verse 12. Bible says, concerning Joseph, have you commanded your day since the morning? Job chapter 20, 38, verse 12. Have you commanded your day since the morning? Hear this and hear me well. Hear this. Because people feel, well, when I'm righteous, I don't sin, then the devil will leave me alone. No, the devil does not leave people alone, even though you are righteous. The devil left Jesus alone. He went to the prayer man to pray, yet he met him there. Righteousness does not make one the devil not attack you. It is only your prayer that will make an edge of protection run about you. Run about you. When we stop praying, things begin to happen. When we stop praying, we begin to see calamity. Be a man that can take hold of his destiny or his family destiny. If there's a man to pray, there's a God to answer. Bible talk about Elijah. Say Elijah was a man of life, yet he prayed earnestly. You think Elijah just prayed at the afternoon? They say, well, let there be no rain. And no, he spent quality and praying through the night. So he can come out and command the day. He can come out and make a declaration. Hallelujah. Midnight is a crucial time. Hallelujah. Number 5. Midnight prayers give us insight to the unknown. I'm going to dwell more on this. Midnight prayer give us insight to the unknown. I am a prophet. Most of the time when I prophesy, when I go to place to preach and I begin to caucus, some of the cases I was calling, I saw them at my place of prayer at night, not even in the hall there. When I say there's somebody here, your name is this, and I begin to describe what you're wearing in a big crusade ground. It didn't just happen there. I saw it at night. So what happened at that crusade ground on the church, it came as a flash to remind me what he told me the answer that night. And I could say, there's somebody here, this and that, this and that, this and that, this command. And it shocked some of the people who have been to a meeting. When I call a case and I call, say, you are here, come out. If you didn't come out, I can make sure where you are, the row you are, the side. If you didn't come out, I can even go and bring you out. I saw this thing before. So I'm not guessing, I can bring you. I brought some of the people out in my administration. I called a case, they couldn't come out, I can bring them out. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Midnight is a time whereby God will have an insight. I remember one of the night, one of the VG, somebody invited me to, a prophet invited me to his church at the VG. Now, it was a night full of miracles. I was calling out cases of people and all that. They were confirming it, they were coming out. So, when I was about to drop, because I need to preach in that church that the same night, I was having two meetings. So, I need to finish for 1, 2 o'clock, then rush to the other church. So when I was about to drop my phone, the Holy Ghost told me, say, look, there's a young man that I need to call out. And I said, there's a young man here. Your wife died. I called the year that the wife died. Your wife died so here mysteriously. Come out. The man didn't come out. I repeated it 3 times. The man didn't come out. And the host pastor, the prophet, was looking at his wife. I said, maybe could it be this man miss it? Now, when God opens your eyes to see things, give you an insight, you don't miss it. Hallelujah. Amen. You don't miss it. So the man refused to come out, and I jumped down from the podium. I said, the man is in this role. I mentioned the role, the man is in this role. I said, but if I pick you out with judgment. So when I said that the man was sitting, people's hearts are so deep in that even in the midst of the prophetic, they see that God. I told him, I said, when I pick you out with judgment, how can a man don't know you before? Mention that your wife died mysteriously. Mention the year your wife died. You still sitting down? And I begin to count. I say, the man is in this, so I'm going to count. I'm going to pick you. I say, 1, 2. When I mentioned today, the man on the fifth row, on the fifth chair, jump out. And the prophet went back to me. Say, they wanted to make a man of God a liar. I said, no. God does not lie. This man that lie. When God showed me, and I said it, if he didn't come, I'll bring you out. And all this information comes through in my place of prayer at midnight. When you see a man that prays so much, it's a man that have an insight. Hallelujah. Midnight give us insight. Deuteronomy chapter 33, verse 6. We saw a man that his father caused. Deuteronomy, read for me. I'm gonna. We saw a man, Reuben, that father caused. Now, 33, verse 6. At this time, this man was not alive then, was not born. Deuteronomy 33, verse 6.
Let Reuben live and not die. And let not his men be few.
Now, this was what Moses was saying. At this time, when the curse was pronounced, Moses was not even born. How did Moses didn't even look at the Torah, the book, to read whether there was a man called Reuben cursed? At this time, even Reuben is gone, but his generation was still suffering the curse of his father, of his grandfather. Because his father, Reuben's father, made a pronouncement that Reuben, that was unstable. Now, let me show you the call. Go back to Genesis. Genesis chapter 49, verse 3 to 4. Yes.
Reuben, thou art my first son. My might and the beginning of my strength.
Dignity,
yes. And the excellency of power.
Yes.
Unstable as water.
Thou shalt not excel.
Thou went up to thy father's bed. Thou defilest it. He went up to my couch.
Now, this was a curse that Jacob pronounced when he was about to die. Because when Jacob was in Egypt, when Jacob was sick, he was about to die. He called Joseph. He said, gather all my children. Let me tell them what's going to befall them at the end of the day. And the beginning, it started from the firstborn, and it was making pronouncement. And I believe the other people, when they started with Reuben, and maybe they're shocked that Reuben are my firstborn. And when they said Reuben are my firstborn, strength of my essence and dignity of my pride, Reuben was laughing. He said, but he never knew something was coming. He said, but thou shalt not excel. You are unstable like water. You may not know that water is unstable. If you doubt me, when you wake up tomorrow morning, put a water in a big bowl, then drop a plastic cup. You're going to see it's going to be shaking. So Jacob said, thou shalt not excel. They are unstable. Now, when Jacob made this pronouncement, Jacob died. Reuben died. and the generation began to suffer unstableness. And God just gave Moses an insight. Say, oh, that's the generation of Reuben. And he reversed the course. Let Reuben live and not die. Is there a cause going on in your family? I stand in the order of Moses tonight. And I say that cause is terminated.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That cause of death is terminated.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let Reuben live and not die. Let Reuben live and not die. In some family, people die before they get to 50 years. I cancel that decree.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
In some family, people don't marry on time. Their women must get to 40 years before they marry. I'll terminate that curse now.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let Reuben live and not die. Let Reuben live and not die. Is there a curse run in your family like a relay? Is there a curse run in your family like an ocean water? Today, I put an end to it.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let Reuben live and not die. As a man of God, as he sleeps tonight, God is going to give you an insight of things that will happen. I could be here and I'm beginning to decode things that happen in other places. When people come in for prayer, most of the time I describe what is going on in the environment. I describe what is going on in their life. They wonder. Hallelujah. Insight. I called a pastor. I've not been to a church, but we met in a meeting. I called him some time ago. It was last year. I said, I want to describe where your church is. He was looking at me because these are people who does not believe in prophetic. I said, your church. I saw three duplex building by your church. He said, that's correct. I saw that you are having parking problem. I said, that's correct. I said, there's a duplex by this side. I said, the owner is going to sell it for you. He said, well, man, you've not been to my church. How do you know? Inside that I can look at you and tell you what is going on in your life. Inside, all this will come as a result of prayers. Some time ago, a lady called me. She was in the hospital. She called me, said, Pastor, pray for me. I want to go and preach. So I pick up the phone to pray. I said, I'm seeing what is going on in your tummy. I see something. He said, that is the pain now. They want to open me up to check. I said, they should not open you up because they won't see anything. I was not in the hospital, but I was describing what is going on in our body. Inside. All this came through a place of prayers. When you see a man that prays so much, it's a man that can see. Today, pastor don't pray. Some pastor don't pray. That pastor don't pray. How can a pastor be in the church? People are dying every month. If God will not tell you, no. You must pray. He said, is there anything I will do in Israel without first revealing to my servant, Abraham? That I speak mouth to mouth. Pastor can quote all the grammar without prayer. The devil can still challenge you. Pastor cannot cast out demons. Grammar does not cast demons. The devil does not submit to grammar. He submits to what I call the anointing. English people call it anointing. I am he. Not English. Not because you have a PhD. When I see some pastor put, I'm not against title. They'll say Reverend Doctor. Somebody are not even medical doctor. They went to theology. You think if you put doctor in front of your name, the devil will run away? No. It is your encounter with God that will make the devil to run away. Prayer is a place of insight. You can notice. We're going to pray tonight. Midnight prayer cancel the evil at noonday. Midnight prayer cancel the evil at noonday. Before the evil come at noonday, when you pray at the night, you cancel it. Now Psalm 121, verse 6 to 8. It was talking about the arrow that flies at noonday. Now those arrows does not start flying at noonday. They commanded it to fly at noonday. The magician did something at night. He said, well, by in the morning, when that Mr. So-so is going to work, hit him or hit her. They did a projection at night. Hallelujah. Psalm 121, verse 6 to 8.
Then the The sword shall not smite thee by day.
The sword shall not smite thee by day.
Not even by night.
Not even by night.
The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil.
Yes,
it shall preserve thy soul.
It shall preserve thy soul.
The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in.
Amen.
From this time forth and even forevermore.
There are magicians who speak to the sun at night. Say, sun, tomorrow when the sun comes, I project this person's name. Let that day not favor the person. You think you can just go and meet somebody to give you money and they just give you the money like that? No, you need to command it. You need to command it. You need to command it. Cancel every... now, hear this. Most of the time when people promise you something they didn't give to you, don't blame them. They have it in mind to give you, but somehow this happened at night. You say, I know that social person is coming to collect, but don't give him. The same person who told you yesterday, say, don't worry, come, I'll give to you. Say, no, I've changed my mind. We need to cancel things at night. Cancel calamity at night. If you read Genesis chapter 18, verse 28, Bible talking about Abraham. Abraham began to intercede for Sodom and Gomorrah. It was in the night that the angel met him. Lot was not a man of prayer. Check through the Bible, you'll see where Lot prayed. Lot was like his father. They like to rock. Because how did I know? Because his father died young. When Lot's father died, Abraham had to take Lot. Primarily the father died. Now watch this. If you read the Bible, you will see where Abraham father married for Lot. He didn't marry. Maybe Lot's father just pregnant a girl and give birth. They rock like so. Lot took after his father. Lot couldn't cancel anything. That is why when it was with Abraham, Abraham was telling him, "Say, we don't need to quarrel among ourselves. You choose where you want to stay, where your cattle will stay." And he look at Sodom. He say, "I want to stay in Sodom." When you see things in the spirit, you will know whether the right place to go. It was in Sodom that God met Abraham. He said, "Look, I am going to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah because evil things going to happen." It was midnight. And Abraham began to intercede. He said, if you see 50 people there, 40, 30, 20, 10. Why did Abraham stop at 10? Because he felt that the household of a Lord, there must be 10 saved. Lord, his wife, maybe the children, and the servant. If not, Abraham could have gone, what if you see 2 people there? He said, no, I believe that Lord will have 10 people in the family. He couldn't see. The angel went that night. And it was in the night, not in the day, they began to bring down Sodom. And they spoke to Lot, say, escape to the mountain, lest that be consumed. So we cancel evil decree at midnight. Lastly, midnight bring restoration to us. Midnight bring restoration. Midnight prayer bring restoration. If you want greatness, come and pray in the night. Before you ask someone for help to help you, spend some quality time to pray in the night. Before you can go for that job interview, spend some quality time to pray at night. If you read the book of Luke chapter 18 verse 1, Luke chapter 18 verse 1, Jesus was talking about the parable. He said, he spake a parable unto them to this end, that men ought always to pray and not to faint. Men ought always to pray. He said there was a city, a Job, who feared not God, nor regarded man. He said, but because of this woman coming, trouble let me. She's a woman of prayer. She keep going, say, avenge me, my adversary. Give me that that belong to me. Probably the husband was not a man of prayer, so this man died. The husband does not believe in prayer. The husband died. And they took everything. He said, well, when I get to heaven, I'll get one. But the wife said, no. I know you didn't understand mystery of prayers. You've gone, but I'm going to place a demand to get that belong to me. This woman began to meet the Job. Bible said, the Job said, do I fear no man? Say, but because of this woman, if you think by a woman, you cannot pray. In fact, women are women of prayers. Women stay more in the place of prayers than even men. Men are distracted. Be here. Stay in the place of prayer. That sickness will not kill you. Stay in the place of prayers. Men always want to pray and not to faint. If you read Esther chapter 6, verse Bible says, on that night that the king could not sleep, and he asked for the book of the Chronicles, the book of remembrance. What made the king not to sleep? Because Esther began to pray. Esther told her, say, go and tell them to fast in Shushan. Say, I and my husband will fast likewise, and I will pray, and I will meet the king. If I perish, I perish. So Esther didn't go and approach the king until she entered the place of prayers. When Esther began to pray, God began to touch the heart of the king. And chapter 1, Esther chapter 6, verse 1. He said, on that day that the king could not sleep, he now demanded the book of Chronicles. God restore Mordecai back. Child of God, you need to pray. You need to pray. Don't blame that man that promised you something he didn't give you. You need to pray. Don't blame that woman that promised you didn't fulfill the promise. You need to pray. If you want your destiny to be restored, that of your family to be restored, you need to enter the midnight prayers. Oh God, turn it around. Turn it around. Turn it around. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We need to enter the place of prayers. Good name does not make one prosperous. Good name does not protect anyone. It is your covenant, your prayer with God that makes you to reshaping your destiny. I tell a story about in the Bible. Adam. When Adam had the first child called Cain, the second was Abel. Bible says that Adam was a tiller of soil. At that time, Adam never knew that God had caused the soil, the ground. Why? Abel was a cattle raiser. So when they came to give sacrifice, Abel brought what God did not cause. Fat cow and offer it to God. And God had received his sacrifice. But Cain, he brought it from the ground. I've gone already called. And when people say, well, and Cain brought it very ugly thing, it's not that. Cain couldn't understand why God didn't accept it. God does not accept sacrifice based on the volume. No. When people say, well, and Cain brought a very. No, it's not that. If you can bring a small sacrifice and God will accept it. Why did God reject the sacrifice of Cain? Not because it was small. Because Cain's heart was not right to God. And what Cain brought, God already caused it. So God didn't accept it. And when God accepted the sacrifice of Abel, Cain was jealous. Bible says that Cain killed his brother. Brother killed his brother. Can you imagine that? At that time, Adam and Eve, they don't have other children again. But well, since Cain is gone, and God have caused since Abel is gone, and God have caused Cain, then let's discuss to have another child. And they have another child called Seth. And Bible says, if you read Genesis chapter 4, verse 20-26, it says, when Seth was born, say, men now begin to call upon the name of the Lord. So Seth is an initiated prayers. The meaning of Seth means anointed. The meaning of Seth means compensation. Seth means compensation. Means anointed. It says, Seth now initiated prayers. He said, men begin to call upon the name of the Lord. Prior to that time, men does not pray. Men does not pray. But when Seth was born, Noah was born, men begin to call upon the name of the Lord. Child of God, if you want to take over your generation, you need to pray. I'm looking for a time, waiting for a time where man, indeed, we're going to happen in this era that men will begin to pray and miracle begin to happen. No boundaries. Hallelujah. Are you ready to pray tonight?
Yes, sir.
This is all night prayers. We're going to pray. If you can pray in tongues, you're going to pray in tongues. Something is about to happen. Your destiny is about to reshape it. You're going to enter a level that will shock your enemies. You have an advantage today to pray. That sickness will not kill you. Pray it out. Pray it out. That name they give to you that you are barren, you cannot be barren. Your womb is fruitful. It says, go and multiply. Your womb is fruitful. You can bear a baby. That business can prosper again. Let's enter the place of prayer. Come on, let's begin to pray. Kalo para hayatas. Jeke lo para neke no koraba hayates. Kelo marake ri kabare de kosi kalabros. Jelo baraka heke ri maraka yete. Yes, Lord, begin to pray wherever you are. Wherever you are watching me from. either on YouTube or Instagram, or you are watching me on Facebook right now, please, I come, begin to pray, begin to pray. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. Men learn always to pray and not to faint. Kantehi kabara keli halos. Jeli kabana sehi konumano. Embro suli kanahaye dehe kibinahaya. Kado saita kandeliyeho. Jeli kandeho sahaya. Bako banahaya taha. Akilinoko akapayana akalev alaha hoyata. Begin to pray, begin to pray. Reshaping your destiny. Reshaping your destiny. Take hold of your day. Take hold of your day. Have you commanded your day since the morning begin? Before you step out of your house, take hold of your day. Ka go pana kali kebina haya. Rubele satiaka. Akodina kombala katen kalahaya. Kento si keminando hura hayete. Are you been answered? If I can see a man, I can pray, I can change destiny of a family. Watchman, what shall deny? God have make you a watchman of our family. Kapayata. Ekopayata. Evil is far away from you. Kene kopana kateki karaha. Hikepina ko balakatin seida. Anduri sabina kon kalaha kigere. Jineme kalaka parahate kiya. Praying mystery. Don't be tired. Praying mystery. If you don't have to pray, just say Jesus. Praying mystery. Kanti kapayata. Rute kapalaka rute ita. Liado siyahabanaha. Riado, I won't give you a prayer point. Just pray it out. Pray it out. Baka kakayata. Iyakota. Bande kiyotos. Iyakota. Bande kiyato. Ebinako. Dentrum palanti ken muton sahayada. Prayer is a mystery. Ken talahayaba. Control your city through prayer. Control your city through prayer. Take hold of your family through prayer. Be kanakataya. He kam parakom parhaya. Gekende ekuramandaha kikediasu. Rusehine mira halahiko. Ekrume hiatase kipira hare. Ikenina hakaloki rika baraka. Akando keke riaha. Ileton sahaka barakata. Ileken sahake birekenda. Eko di kini kalaka ba. Eyato ebekeye. Prayer will change this. Kakahaya. Jelikahaya pa. In the name of Jesus Christ. Now talking about Jacob, Bible says, and there came an angel and wrestled with Jacob until the breaking of the day. If you know what is pursuing you, wrestle to the night. Hallelujah. Paul was speaking to the people, said, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, against principalities, against powers. You can't confront that evil man in the daytime without prayers. You can't go to the other office and sit down like that as if it's heaven. No. Prayers. He said, until the breaking of the day. He said, when the day break, the angel said, look, allow me to go. He said, I will not allow you to go until you bless me. And the angel touched his thigh. And Bible said that he is injured. Why? Because so that Jacob could keep depending on God. He kept depending on God, a place of encounter. And God changed the name of Jacob. He said, your name shall no longer call Jacob. Because before then, he was a supplanter. He said, but your name shall call Israel. Israel. Hallelujah. We need to pray again for the next 1 minute. Oh God, change my destiny. Rewrite my history, Lord. I must make a mark in my generation. Rewrite my history. Kalu katiyata. Keruma hayata. Pray for your children. Pray for your children. Ke ko bana kali seliao. Meruse ininaha Gekunaha rahe kebiyahe Jerosu ninada Akingodo sahaya Deliso tina mahakiso Deliso rika minaha tatisio Berikado salaha katata. Yes Lord, yes Lord. It's not time to watch TV. Pray, pray. Let something happen at the daytime. Kanakeyaha. Take hold on this mystery. Take hold on this mystery. Take hold on this mystery. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Keminuhu parahashata. Zusekina harakuti libraha. Nehiyakus. Nehiyakus. Nehiyaku. Nehiyakus. Nehiyaku. Nehiyaku. Salingina maharabohi. Tantori debinaha yaka. Yes, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Now, Bible says, iron sharpened iron, deep calling unto deep. I'm going to pray as many as worship me right now. That let the gods of heaven strengthen your hands. He said, blessed be the Lord who teaches my hands to war. In the battle of life, you will not be a victim.
Amen.
Stretch your hand to the screen where you are watching me from. You that is watching me right now. In the battle of life, you will not be a victim.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Lord will fight for you.
Amen.
And you hold your peace.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will not die suddenly.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will not lose any loved ones.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Before anything will happen, the Lord will reveal to you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
May the Lord strengthen you.
Amen.
May the Lord keep you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, my God and my Father. We give you praise. We give you honor. Hallowed be your name, O Lord. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name I pray. Now tonight, as you go to bed, please, any dream you have, just pay attention to it. Mark it. Or write it down. Because dreams are information that God is telling us so that we can know how to arrange our life on daytime. So when you have any dream, please write it down. You can even share the dream with me. You can send me a WhatsApp on the dream you have or encounter you have tonight on +277 302 0 7440. All right, send on WhatsApp. I will interpret the dream for you. You may have a dream, maybe you don't understand the dream. I will send me the meaning of the dream, how the dream, I will interpret it for you. The Lord have given us the secret. Daniel was saying, he said, there's a God in heaven that reveals secret. When the king had a dream, Daniel was not there. But Daniel came saying, understand the language of the kingdom. Daniel began to say, I saw you in a dream and you saw in a handwriting, writing. And began to say, many was speaking in that tongue that Daniel could, that even the king could understand. But Daniel said, we understand that language. It's a coded language. Mene, mene, take, ufase. We know that language. So Daniel could be able to interpret it before the king. How can you tell the king the dream he dreamed and you're not there? And give him the interpretation. Please, if you have any dream tonight or maybe any subsequent dream, send me the dream. I'm going to, on that WhatsApp number, I'm going to interpret the dream. If it's an evil dream, we cancel it. If it's a good dream, we not proclaim it, we not claim it to pass. But I tell you, you're not alone in this battle. In this lockdown, I'm with you. Your brother is here to pray with you. Don't be shy to send me your prayer request. Don't be shy to share your testimony with me. I'm going to stand with you until you succeed. God bless you. We'll see you on Sunday. And I believe God that the same God that called me will respond to you in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, those who are going to watch me later or now, if you don't know Jesus, I want you to just surrender your life to Jesus. Say, Lord Jesus, I come to you tonight. Please have mercy upon me. I am a sinner. Write my name in the book of life. From today, I'm born again. Devil, leave me alone. I belong to Jesus. Now that I'm saved. In Jesus' name. Now you made that confession, you are saying, because Bible says in the book of Romans chapter 10, it says, with the mouth who made confession is made with heart will believe. We'll confess through the mouth, will believe through our heart. If you made that confession, God has saved you. Don't let the devil deceive you that God have not saved you. If God can save me as a former DJ in a nightclub, God can still save you. Alright? Let us hear your testimony of how God saved you, your counter. God is going to use you the way he's using me. Alright? God is going to raise a prophet through the people, raise evangelists, raise prophetess, and your life will not remain the same. I see you on Sunday. I'm going to be online too. We're not opening our church on Sunday. We're going to be online on Sunday. So connect with us online on Sunday, 10 o'clock in the morning, South African time. And I'm going to share more light on commanding total dominion. You're going to take charge of your dominion. The devil will not command you. You're going to take control of your destiny. Please go to our YouTube page, subscribe to our YouTube channels, like our page, also share, so that anytime we upload new messages, you could be the first one to get a lot and listen to it. As a matter of fact, when the nation open up the churches again, I will still keep on to online broadcasting. I'm not used to online broadcasting, but now this have come to stay. We could be doing that. Hallelujah. God bless you. And I see you online also on Sunday.